Hello everyone, this is Maureen from Mosie Baby. In this video, I'll talk to you about your cervix and why it's important when trying to figure out when you're ovulating. If you're like me, your reproductive education was pretty modest. You learned about your period when you were a little girl, you grew up, spent your entire sexual life trying not to get pregnant, then you switch gears and all you can think about is why am I not pregnant yet? Most likely it's because you, like me and most women, know very little about your cycle and your lady parts. No joke, until I started down my pregnancy journey, I had no idea what was in my vagina. It was an area I thoroughly avoided. But now that I do know, I can tell you that's actually pretty awesome. So let's go and learn about it. Okay, what is your cervix? Your cervix is the gatekeeper and kind of the cheat sheet to figuring out the optimal time for conception, as it reveals when you're preparing to ovulate and when you're ovulating. In the process of learning about your cervix, you will inevitably learn about your cervical mucus, which is one of the reasons why I feel it's a quick cheat to understanding where you are in your cycle. Think about this. When you go into labor, your progress during labor is measured by how dilated your cervix is, meaning how open your cervix is and how ready it is to release your baby into the world. It is the opening that connects the vagina to the uterus. Just as your cervix is a tool to measure progress during labor, it is also a tool to measure where you are in your fertility cycle every month. Imagine this is your vagina. You put things in here, tampons, Mosie syringes, whatever else you like to do in the privacy of your own home. On the far end of your vagina is your cervix. On the other side is your uterus. Your cervix is a tunnel sperm must pass through in order to rendezvous with an egg and make a baby. Your cervix is also the place where all that lovely gooey fluid originates from, called cervical mucus. During your fertile days, your cervix and your cervical mucus will change, making it easier for sperm to survive and pass on through the cervix. Amazingly enough, your cervix is designed to make this journey easier when you're ovulating by rising up in your vagina, becoming softer, and actually opening up. Also amazingly enough, when your body is not ready to make a baby, your cervix will change again, becoming hard, lowering in your vagina, and actually closing up. So now that you know your vagina is not a black hole and the magic of your cervix, let's go and find it. See you in the next video or visit us at mosiebaby.com for all things home fertility.